What has been changing over the last weeks or 2 or 3 months is the perception that the downside risks for the global economy and the European economy are not so tilted to the downside as they were only 2 or 3 months ago. So that's the main issue. What are these downside risks? First of all, Brexit. I think that the possibility of a no deal that was quite evident only 2 or 3 months ago. Now, I think that I would not say that it's totally off the table, but I think that this possibility is much lower than only 2 or 3 months ago. And simultaneously, I think that the question of a trade war, the escalation of a trade war, I think that now is after the conversations and the possibility of a trade agreement between China and the US. I think that also is not so evident, so tangible as it was only 2 or 3 months. I think that these two factors are weighing on the perception about the evolution of the economy. They were extremely detrimental to the global economy and to the European economy, and so as they are becoming, let's say, not so evident, I think that this is having an impact on the perception that investors have with respect to the evolution of the global economy and the European economy.
Could that also have an effect on monetary policy? Because clearly the September decisions were taken in the light of a very gloomy economic picture.
Well, but I would say that, the package of September, was the correct one. We have to see, how the effects of this package start to be evident, and I think that now they are becoming evident. And I think that we are data dependent, as we have said many times. No, but what we are looking at is a sort of improvement in the perception about the downside risks. So that's the first step, yes. But that's enough in order to modify our outlook. Well, we will see how this evolution of the potential risks evolve over time.
Hi, I'm Giovanna Bersecci, and thank you for watching. You can check out more of our videos by clicking on the boxes on the screen. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more from CNBC International. Thank you for watching.